with Sugarbees and Candace. Tell us what's going on today.
So we have this lovely group of ladies. We're going to try out some of our keto baked goods that we're doing in the shop. We've been baking in the shop for about a year now. Keto, personally, I've been baking keto for 2.5 years or so. So it's been kind of a trial and error process. And I think we have it pretty honed in now, even from the time when we started baking in the shop till now. But we wanted to bring some goodies out for you guys to try. We have a few different options, one savory and four sweet.
All right, so now our judges. We have our three ketoers. We have Daniela, April, and Susie. And then Diana is our non-keto.
So far,
you might be
awesome. Now, Candace, real quick, can you just tell us, explain what keto is? What makes a dessert keto friendly?
Okay.
Yeah.
So basically, keto is just a lifestyle, a way of eating. It's not a diet. It's very low carb, high protein, high fat. It changes your body into burning fat for fuel rather than your glucose that you would normally get from eating carbs and sugar. So it's a healthy way for your body to burn fat and stay healthy. A lot of people think you're eating so much fat and everything, how can you be healthy? But it's very good for you, actually. Like, lowers the bad cholesterol and raises your high cholesterol as long as you're following everything properly. But for the baked goods, it's all almond or coconut flour based, and we use a sugar alcohol in replacement of like traditional sugar, so it has no effect on your glucose levels. So it's actually a pretty good way of eating your sweet treats, which are normally forbidden on a keto diet, or keto lifestyle.
And does keto stand for something?
Yeah.
It's ketogenic. Yeah.
Ketogenic is basically like your body goes into ketosis.
Gotcha.
You're using it that way, scientific stuff.
Lots of science.
Yeah,
lots of science.
We like goodies, not so much science.
Awesome.
But baking keto can be pretty scientific, but we've pretty much nailed it down, so I want you guys to give us some.
All right, what are we going to try first?
I think we should go with the savory first.
I do too.
Which is our cheddar jalapeno cornbread muffin. That's this one. Cheddar jalapeno.
Well, I like the cake in it.
The texture is supposed to mimic a
really
cornbread,
yeah.
But it's almond coconut base.
Oh, interesting.
That's super good.
Mm-hmm. So can you taste any almond or coconut? Mm-hmm. Can you get any of those flavors?
No. You really taste the jalapeno.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not, I haven't gotten one of the pieces yet. I've just been eating the bread part.
Mm-hmm.
And you can taste the infusion of it.
Yeah.
Yes.
It bakes in well.
Yeah, you can feel the little cheese in it.
It's really good with like soups or keto chili.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah,
it pairs well.
For those of you just tuning in,
too.
Yeah.
This is our taste test Friday
this is
with
what
Sugarbee,
we just
keto,
right?
Yeah, exactly.
This is interesting.
Oh, Diana's going in for more.
I was over 200 pounds. I was diabetic. I didn't want to go on insulin or any medication. So and then I went on a keto diet. My daughter was in a wheelchair. And she was getting chubby. She goes, I want to lose a little weight. She was only like 11 years old. So I said, okay, I'll feed you this way. So we both ate it. She lost a little weight. I lost the weight. I no longer had to take insulin. She got out of her wheelchair. It's an amazing diet.
Wow. We hear the story a lot in the store.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And people have come in diabetic.
Yes.
Customers have come in after buying things and trying it at home and coming back and saying that they've tested their insulin after and have zero spikes.
Zero spikes,
yes. Different diabetics as well. If you guys want to try next, the KETO Raspberry Coffee Cake, that one's almost like a mixture of a cake and a cookie towards the bottom. It's an almond base, and it has a cream cheese and almonds and raspberry.
And which one are we trying?
That's this one. It's the raspberry coffee cake.
This one might be
good.
Oh, that one's beautiful.
It is good.
Raspberry. It's really good with the sour tart of the raspberry with the sweet from the cream cheese and the cake.
So what's your most popular keto dessert?
This one, the raspberry coffee cake, and the cheesecakes and the peanut butter bars are our number one sellers.
That.
We've added the other ones recently, so they're picking up speed, but we sell a good amount.
It's so nice we can come down here and do this and not feel guilty.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
This
the
is amazing.
The raspberry is so good.
No, No guilt.
I would never have guessed.
All right, texture wise, what do we have going on?
This is different from the muffin, don't you girls think so?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Smoother.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the cream cheese mixes well with like the crumbly, so it's not just like crumbling in your mouth, but it's kind of like smooth.
It's crumbly and moist. So,
yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, it's both.
There we go.
So in this whole square here, you will have a total of 3.2 carbs.
Wow.
So it's pretty large. If you wanted to divide it in half, you could have it twice and only 1.5 carbs.
Wow. Pretty good. So with the keto diet, you're counting more the carbs than
you
the calories?
You want to say 20 net carbs or below every day.
20?
So in this whole piece, is 3.2.
Can you believe that?
That's and one thing I can say about our shop, you can count on our macro count. We've done the science, we've done the math, we've done the measuring. We're very careful when we make it to be sure that we're very close to what we provide you as far as the information. Which can be deceiving in a couple places.
Yeah, sometimes it's like keto, but it's like 16 carbs, and you're like, well,
that's not really
I can have like a bite. And
I have
okay.
seen a lot of that.
Yeah.
Well, that is very satisfying.
Good. Yeah, I think so. Being that keto, do you feel that there's any?
There is a slight different texture from a regular, type of cake that way.
That's the almond.
But it's not.
You're not missing anything.
No, but you really don't have any weird like aftertaste or
not
anything from the sugar substitute.
No, and it's sweet enough that it helps. Because I'm a sweetie.
Diana, you like your sweets.
Right? I do like my sweets, yeah.
So while we're on the creamy kick, we should go ahead and try the cheesecake. It's a cinnamon cheesecake bite.
Again, you can probably cut it in half. Yeah. The total net carbs is 3 in the whole muffin.
It's like flour and butter and sweetener.
It's really good.
Very good.
Good.
I ate my all.
You guys like that? The texture is good, right?
Yeah.
It's really good. Besides the chocolate.
Yeah, so if you want to go for chocolate, we're just going to keep going. The next one is the chocolate donut, and it has a bit of a...
One net carb for a whole donut?
A whole donut.
Now, isn't that better than a slice of bread?
I would say so. Yeah.
So this is like our very low carb option.
The donut
is your lowest carb option?
Yeah.
The texture is super nice.
It's very
it's
little
very
cocoa
moist.
Powder,
yeah.
And then
really
just
good.
Like the cream and butter.
It really makes a difference.
Do you have other
textures?
Right now, this is the one we've been doing.
Okay.
It took us a bit to get this one just right.
Mm-hmm.
So that we don't put things out until it's just right.
Right.
Until keto and non-keto people both can enjoy it, we won't put it out.
That's
kind of
interesting.
We do the glaze. Yeah. Well, we do have a pretty good glaze.
Oh, do you?
Yeah. We're working on it.
Okay.
I'm working on a lemon bar right now.
Oh,
that one should be good for springtime.
That's a good one.
Lemon bar. Okay.
All right. We have one more, right?
One more.
Yeah, that's the peanut butter bar. And this is by far our biggest seller.
Is this the regular slice?
Okay. Yeah, that's the serving size. So I can give you the macros for that one, too.
Really rich.
Mm-hmm.
Over like indulgent.
There's just like a meal.
Susie's eyes just got so big and happy.
It's super good.
That is really good.
Tastes like a recess.
It's like diet.
So this one's a little bit higher in carbs, 3.6 for
net?
The whole bar.
Net?
Yes.
Oh, still.
3.6 is
I thought it was going to be higher, so this is good.
But yeah, for a dessert, and that's a lot of people will say because it has like a protein powder in it too, so you're getting a good amount of protein. You're getting five grams of protein, 5.5.
No, I don't have protein powder in it. Is that for part of the baking process, or does
for keto diet, you want to have a balance of low carbs and your protein and fat, so you have like a percentage that you're trying to achieve based on your body weight. Most people know what theirs are.
Is there any fiber in it?
Yes. I can tell you that, but I would have to look it up.
Oh, okay.
Mm. All right, but what we do is calories, so it's 216, 19 are from fat, 5.5 protein, and then 3.6 of the net carbs.
Oh, okay.
So it's pretty good on like the balance as far as like 80-20.
Mm-hmm. I mean, between the carbs and the fat, and I'm sure there's fiber in it because it has peanut butter.
Yeah.
And, you know, something,
it has the natural, no sugar added peanut butter.
I was going to ask you about that. It does,
Oh, yeah, I know some people do cut it in half.
And then you don't feel bad
it.
When you eat it.
There you go.
The to say you're in a hurry.
You like this, Deborah? Yeah.
It's good post-workout, too.
Good chocolate.
Oh, there we go. So,
yeah. Oh. Yeah, it's a good snack. Post or pre-workout.
All right, Candace, so do you also follow keto, or do you just bake delicious keto?
Oh, no, I do. My husband and I both follow it.
For how long?
Well, I would say I was very, very, very strict for about 18 months, and then I went on vacation and just fell into that thing that everybody does once in a while on keto. But, you know, the thing is, like, you can always just jump right back on. So after holidays, I'm back on now. I've been back on for 8 days and have lost 8 pounds.
And buy a good amount of these treats.
So, at the beginning when we first started offering this, we were doing it by order only. Yep. So people were able to order online on our website and pick up either on Wednesday or Saturday. That has changed. We have full-time baking going on for keto. We're baking multiple times a week. There are times when it sells out quickly, and you know, but we're constantly baking now. So that there's no more need to order in advance. You can walk in and purchase a variety at any given day. We're open 7 days a week. But if there's a specific item that you really want to have, like you want to guarantee that you get, I do recommend ordering online. Because when we bake, we'll package it and set aside just for you. So you're guaranteed to get it. So if there's something specific, then it's a very good idea to order in advance. But it's not necessary anymore.
Awesome. Okay, ladies. What was your favorite?
The donut.
The donut.
Yeah. I was going to say the donut, too. Oh, okay. I love the donut.
Susie, mine was this.
Peanut butter bar.
Yes. In between that and the cheesecake. That cheesecake was just fabulous. That was really unexpected.
And yeah, what's your favorite?
For me personally, I love the cheesecake and I love this raspberry coffee. Mm-hmm. Those are my two go-to's.
I would try the two cookies that they have at the bakery as well, and those are my favorite too.
Oh. Yeah.
Aside from the donut. Yeah.
As far as like cookies go, they're close to a normal cookie, but not
they're
quite.
They're different. There's like a tiny bit of like the coconut. I can taste the coconut. Yeah. The chocolate chips are really good, but my downfalls are cookies, so.
Okay.